Hey guys, coming to you from over here at Wally's house. If you've been following this series of videos before, you've probably seen the hot rod lawn tractor, and I'm just coming by here today to give you a little update on what Wally's been up to and you know, kind of the additions to the lawn tractor. And for those of you that haven't seen it, I'll do like a walk around here so you can see all the little features on it. Wally does you know, paint and body work, so he decided to go ahead and apply a little bit of that to his lawn tractor here. And as you can see, it's got the real flame paint job here and going across the hood and everything. And there's a few little embers here, and then it actually sweeps on up the center section and then up onto the rear fenders here. And you can tell how glossy it is by all that reflection there. And then it comes on across the back, and he's got some embers that kind of lick across the back here. Pretty cool. And up front here, you might have noticed it has this cigar smoking duck up here, and that's the hood ornament from the movie Convoy, if you've seen that. And that's a nickel plated duck. That's pretty cool. Probably the only lawn tractor in the US with that on there. Along the side here, you can see he's added some stickers, like the Borla exhaust stickers and Summit Racing, that kind of stuff. And the most recent addition to the tractor, and what he's been working on, what he was working on yesterday, is he took the factory foot pads here, and he used those as a template, and then he cut out this aluminum diamond plate and made some new foot treads. And then they're actually adhered to the factory pads, and that way they snap into place just like they would have originally, and they can be removed if they need to be cleaned, that kind of stuff. So it's pretty cool. And we'll take a look around here. Out back here, if you recall, I did kind of like a little bit of you know, almost Bomber Girl style artwork back here. It says Sweet Mo, and she's laying in the grass there and everything. Not getting the best focus here, but anyway. And then you can see he painted the wheels in that bright, you know, hot rod kind of red. Pretty cool. And there's your other foot tread plate and everything. And then I'm good and tilt this up here. And for those of you that haven't seen it, he did make a custom exhaust for this as well. And you can see he welded into the factory flange there, and then it comes down. And then what he did here, he took a Harley Davidson muffler, and then he chopped it down to length, and then he actually built multiple chambers inside to get the particular, you know, sound level that he was looking for and everything like that, and the correct back pressure. And then over here you can see he took some round bar and made some custom brackets here to make sure that it was really sturdy. And as you can see, there's multiple points where it comes out to the muffler. And this has been on there for a while and seems to be doing really good. And it gives it kind of a unique sound and look. And you can see he kind of slash cut it out the side, so it's pretty cool looking. Let's see. And this has the 18 horse overhead valve. Take a look at that. But anyway, you know, just a pretty unique looking lawn tractor. And he's got the deck over there. He's doing some work on that right now. And as I mentioned before, this actually is a mower that gets used, and he mows with it all the time, so it is functional. But just pretty unique looking thing. And while we're over here, Wally here, he's been working on another project. He's a pretty creative guy. So what he's been working on lately is a series of these practice knives, you know, for martial artists. And he had these aluminum blanks cut out, and then he's been hand fabricating these handles out of oak hardwood. You can see that it's really smooth in the hand. And he's also actually dipped them in a automotive clear coat, which makes for like a real durable finish. But anyway, I mean, the idea behind it, obviously, is that you can practice your knife techniques, and but there's no edge, and it's blunt around the front here, so no danger of injury, that kind of thing. And what he's got here, he's got a series of different styles. You know, you got your short knife there. This you call a barong, is that what you call
it?
Okay. And you can see fashioned in a, you know, a similar fashion, but obviously a much longer weapon. And as you can see here, it goes all the way through the handles. It's one solid piece of aluminum all the way through, and then these handles are adhered onto here. And I mean, they're just really excellent practice weapons. And then, like I said, if I can get some focus here, he has various styles. So we have one, you know, the small one, then the large barong, and then we have this intermediate size. And they're all really nicely weighted and kind of approximate the feel of a real weapon. Obviously a bit lighter, but balance-wise, they feel really good in your hand and everything. And he's going to actually be selling sets of these or individually here in the future. But anyway, the plan is in the near future here, I'm going to get my son or someone else to assist me, and we'll make a video of some knife removal techniques, you know, some blade techniques, that kind of thing, and we'll use Wally's practice knives and show you those in action, so that'd be pretty cool. But anyway, we're just out here working on the tractor, and I thought I'd give you a look around. And Wally got the idea to put the tractor up here on the porch, because I don't know if you guys can tell, but the wind is like blowing crazy all the way around us today, so we had to kind of tuck up in here under the porch. But anyway, this video is getting pretty long, so we're gonna call it a day, and I'll talk to you guys later. See ya. Bye.